a Sunday. That yesterday felt like Sunday, today feels like Monday, even though it's Sunday. So like, I'm not expecting anything wild in the email department, but that's usually my excitement on Mondays, is that. Anywho, I am literally being productive while filming this because I spent all day. Now, notice all these nice close-ups. That's because if I don't go close-up, you realize this entire place is a giant mess. Now, let me explain something to you. The carpet smells like a lot. It's a new carpet. It's been new carpet since like last Tuesday, I think, if it's that. And let me just show you the situation, okay? It's been fun. Now, earlier today, they actually undid the entire bathroom because it was filled with like, wow, that was really bright. Anyway, it was filled with like a lot of like tarp and stuff. It was just being blocked off because the actual, okay, I know the light's not on, but let me show you. So here's the shower. And the ground, like, that totally got sealed. So they just sealed up the bottom. The rest of it's kind of like as it's been. But the bottom's new. We're still questioning, like, not to use it for a bit. But it should be fine, like, within a day or two. So that's cool. That being said, if you go over here, okay, now that needs to be cleaned again. So that's fun. But I just started running that in here. It does have like a little Febreze scent in it. We don't have any Febreze, but like I wanted to try to like clean out the smell of the carpet because that just smells like nail polish. Like it's not that bad and it's also kind of like gone already, but the carpet is disgusting and I don't want to put any clothing back until I do that. So that's what's running there. Unrelated note, we've got some boxes. Now this is a condensed version of what it was, but it's so much better because I just wanted like the essential boxes. Basically those are like the one for the coffee machine, the one for the pillow. I mean, I guess it wouldn't be it for the pillow, but like just keeping essential things for boxes. And then we got a bunch of random other boxes that away. So this is a new empty bin. I actually emptied this out and moved some stuff into that one. I got a couple more bins. Actually, no, it was into that one. But yeah, I got a couple of my bin situations here, and I'm just going to leave those on the ground because it's been easy to do that. So yeah, I also like cleaned off the entire counter and the mirror, so it's super fresh and nice, and I kind of like half changed because this gal was auditioning earlier today, so that's what we do. I actually cleaned down this entire thing, which is awesome because this mirror finally got cleaned after many years. I got that freshman year, so it's been a long time. I cleaned off this, which is a fun fact. If you know, you know. Yeah. So we've cleaned off pretty much all of this, like super sanitary, very nice, moved stuff in. Recently found out that Brenna had this random cool little diffuser thing. And I was literally just talking about how like, okay, so I was just talking about how it's so weird that I was sent in one of those influencer collective boxes, the air freshener thing. And obviously we're having a lot of weird symptoms right now because of how like the carpet smells really bad and just like not great. So that combined with the cleaning smells, combined with the shower situation, like everything is really, really intense with fumes. And chemically, that's just throwing like there's headaches. It's just, it's not feeling great over here, okay? So I mean, it's still great and fine and everything's good, but I am gonna go for a walk because I need nature to set it after I send an audition, which is what I just did, which is why I have my camera out. So that's my plan for today. I need some real air, which is funny because LA air still sucks. But anyway, that's where we're at. So I was saying, oh, it's so weird how like I got that. I was like, I don't know what to do with this, but like, cool. We have this really, really cool diffuser and it's coming in clutch right now. She's like, oh yeah, I got one of those things like that too. I'm like, wait, what? And that's this. This is like a literal oil, like essential oil diffuser, which is awesome because I recently picked up these two to help with the air because the air quality has been really bad. So we have eucalyptus, we also have peppermint, and both are like really good with like the air quality, with headaches, so it's like any digestion issues, which y'all know I have sometimes. But yeah, so like I've kind of used them here and there, but I'm also kind of afraid just like you're not supposed to apply them directly. So if we do it in this, that's gonna help with all these weird funky things that are just kind of happening while we're still trying to clean everything out and make it all better. So hee, so excited. So this is still kind of like a thing, but we'll move stuff back once. Like my entire This is really such a mess, but I'm planning on moving all my closet stuff back in once it smells better because I don't want my clothes to start smelling like that. We have bin of like towels and stuff like that that I've been using. I cleaned off the beach towels from yesterday, so that's all good. So yeah, that's the tea. That's what's happening. I'm kind of just like in the midst of a lot in here, and I really want to just sit back and watch like anything and just relax, because honestly, like, I've been going so like hardcore trying to get all this kind of clean and together, and it's been very overwhelming lately. So obviously the only thing I want to be doing is being very cozy, reading, possibly like just kind of maybe editing, but that's also like, I did a lot of editing last week. I don't know, I really just want to watch stuff. Like, I wanted to see Emily in Paris in that's a Netflix show that just started. So I was like, oh, I shouldn't get more into TV, but I also know I really do want to watch it. It's just one season, so I could probably get away with that pretty quick. Welcome to my life. I don't know what's happening. So yeah, that's where we're at. But also yesterday in general was super peaceful. It was great. It was like the most calming situation, because I started off feeling kind of overwhelmed, but then it got so much better at just reading, listening to chill music, just like vibing and just like laying back and just relaxing on the beach was the best thing. And like the air was really cool, the entire atmosphere got super cool, and it was just like that entire vibe was so good. And reading that book has been awesome. Like the entire first part I read through, and that was like daily things that you can do to kind of just like keep your vibes real high and feel really good. And I just like, I love that, because obviously I'm trying to stay as positive and uplifting and healthy and happy as possible, and I feel like this year has made that way more difficult than normal. But I've also had a lot of good like spiritual growth from this, so yeah, like we love that. So that is my fun update. That's what's going on today. It is just the day where I've been doing a remarkable amount of deep cleaning and feeling warm and a little bit uncomfortable with all the fumes that are going on. So I'm gonna go for a healthy little walk. I might call home during that walk. I might just breathe in the relatively decent LA air and hope for the best. Happy Monday. I don't know why I'm gonna start this week this way, but that's how it is. Good things that have happened today is I've actually moved pretty much all of my closet stuff back into the closet. It's still airing out. I still have things to move around, and I still have a bunch of boxes to decide what to do with, but it's kind of together. And I'm pretty relieved that that's all pretty much done and taken care of at this point, because that was such a huge stressful factor of my previous week. New stressful factor that I've done a lot of today is just applied to like everything. Acting gigs, normal jobs, literally just any sort of money making opportunity, because like my world has shifted again and I have to figure out how to make it work, basically. So that's kind of frustrating, but it's also kind of liberating, because there's so many opportunities, and when I'm not really trying to find like one main thing and thinking way too much about it, it's just cool. Like, I'm able to literally just find whatever random opportunity sounds appealing and just see what happens with it, which I love to do, and I'm very much a person who likes to do a lot of different things, so that's awesome. My throat feels a little bit funky because there's still a lot of scents going on in here. I mean, seriously, the air quality is pretty bad again. It's like 130 something, which isn't great. The new rug is a smell. The serious, like the shower is still being aired out. And literally just in general, I've done a ton of cleaning. So my system is kind of, you know, in the midst of a lot. Plus, like, I was really stressed too, so that did help. But we're getting to the end of that tunnel. My hair's feeling very, very fresh and nice, so that's awesome. And it is nice having a bathroom again, so that really, really helps. Anyway, update on opportunities, because it is a Monday. That means I'm constantly trying to figure out what is going on in my life. One opportunity technically could work out, but personally speaking, it would require me to spend a lot of time alone somewhere I'm not familiar in the slightest, and just that time alone for like quarantining and stuff, I right at this very second, obviously by the time this is posted things are going to be totally different, but as of right as I'm filming this right now, I don't think I'm comfortable being alone for that many days for an opportunity that a lot of people don't feel right about, slightly myself included. But honestly, the main reason I actually was considering this in the first place as an option was literally slightly debunked recently. Like, the one thing I thought would actually make it maybe worth a while, probably isn't the case. So it's tough, but I'm also trying to get to a point where I can be not really like selective in a picky way, but selective in a I'm doing what's best for me way. So I'm spending a lot of time maturing. I spend a lot of time having waves of just rejection moments and feeling like I'm not good enough or feeling like I'm constantly putting myself out there for things and hearing silence. And that's frustrating. It is. Like, this is real emotions. This is how it is. And that's how it goes. And yeah, I've been doing this long enough that it is frustrating and it is stressful and it's not happy-go-lucky 24/7, but I'm so set in knowing what I like to do and that I'm doing the right thing that even feeling like this, it's like a surface feeling. It's like, obviously, all right, fine, I'm human, I'm gonna feel like this. I've got my hopes up for something. And I keep trying. It's not even about like just one thing in particular. It's just a constant trying and feeling like I'm walking against the wall every 2 seconds. And it gets worse when there are scary factors involved and having no concept of what I'm doing, like plus a pandemic, plus becoming really, really stressed because of money now. Like, it's just things I don't always talk about. Things that weren't too much of an issue before because I was kind of really great at abundance and having things working out before, and now it's like not quite to that level, and it's okay, I'm adjusting, that's how it goes, but it still sucks. So yeah. Anyway, I'm fine. It's like, yeah, this happens, big whoop, but like, seriously, it's not the biggest ordeal because technically I could still make something really cool happen out of it, but I also kind of feel like this is directing me towards something better. And I know that seems like the most hopeful, optimistic thing ever, and now part of my like spiraling sadness brain is going, you're being optimistic. But no, seriously, like deep down, I know that I'm being led to great things. I'm being led on this path for a reason, and no matter how hard I try to think about literally any other path or opportunity or anything, even when I try for those other things, I always get redirected back to exactly where I know I need to go. I need to follow the very weird progress wave that I am on and just totally trust, because despite everything, I believe in it so much, and I've had so many reasons all the way through to keep believing. And this may just seem like it's talking about one thing, but as I'm saying it, I'm realizing it's kind of about a lot. There's a lot of things that go to this. It's like, I don't know why, but for whatever reason, it's just, this is how it's working out. So that's my update. We'll go for a walk today. I actually did some laundry. Like I said, putting everything away has been good. Just getting my space back in order, figuring out what's going on. Like, it's kind of just a relief to know where I'm at. And then I like found ways to feel better. And then I was listening to a really great bop that when my throat starts feeling better and the air gets a little bit better, because I really gotta stay healthy here. I'll probably record the actual audio for that and that's it, and see how that turns out, because it's good. It's really good. Like, not to pat myself on the back, but it's pretty great. It's like one of those weird things where I just feel like I'm able to step back and really figure out who I am and what's going on, and there's a lot of maturing and there's a lot of growth, and sometimes I'm totally okay and really, really just high in life and everything's good, and there's other times where honestly I am as low as I've ever been, and it's sucky, and that's nature. But I just have to like understand that it's all going to happen like that in waves, and every single time I hit a low point, it gets a little bit less low the next time, and it provides insight and stuff to make me feel better, and it's just really good to either talk it out or write it out or just walk it out or whatever the case may be, and really just take those maturing moments to grow and listen to a lot of music and really just remember to breathe and eat okay and just like all of that stuff, drink enough water, things like that, because life can be a little bit weird sometimes, but you know, I think this time of self-growth is going to make my future career and life, which is probably everything I dreamed of and more, but like different than, like, I don't know, like I just feel like I have to go through this growth to get to that point and be able to enjoy it to the fullest and like have like long lasting existing opportunities, you know, like, I don't know.
Hi, and welcome back to another lazy, cozy day in my life. Okay, it hasn't been lazy. I've been super productive, just a lot recently with everything that was going on. So the closet's pretty much fully back, and I just need to personally take care of all those boxes. But yeah, like, that's a work in progress, but we're getting somewhere. I do have an audition thing I have to send in today, because I promised I'd do that, which is pretty much that, so that's cool. I just need to, like, it's a quick video I film on my phone just talking about like myself, like personality wise. So I'm like, okay, super simple, I could do that. But yeah, today has been a day I just had like no motivation. Yeah, I mean, I need to pick up groceries because I'm like flat out of food, but I'm also like not feeling like I really want to go out. And honestly, like, I don't know what it is. I think I'm just crashing because like there has been a lot of smells. I know I'm trying to feel better, just from everything that was going on. It was very stressful, very overwhelming, and I'm not exactly in a position where things are dramatically better about that. I still have no idea what's going on, and like, I'm okay with it. So I have my doctor's appointment tomorrow morning, and then I'm supposed to have a party to work on this weekend. Lately, it's like things that used to be so simple and easy, like, kind of just aren't anymore. Like, just mentally, there's more of like a mental hurdle I'm trying to get over just to do even the simplest of things. It could even be like, oh, I should walk outside for a second. Like, I don't really feel like doing that, even though I know once I get there, I'd probably be fine. And then even when I'm there, like, sometimes I'm okay, or like instantly I'm just not. And I don't know, like, I'm saying this just to kind of document how I'm feeling and hopefully talk it out. But also, if you're watching this and you have an idea of what to do about it, or you're also feeling these sorts of things, let me know, because I have no idea.
Okay, obviously I'm still here, so change of plans. I walk up to the car and immediately decide, you know what, I'm getting groceries tomorrow, I can't be bothered today. Like, I'm pretty stinking tired and out of it and kind of like scared about that, so it's too crippling. And I wanted to go to kind of like prove I was okay, and I'm sure I will be, and I am, but I'm also kind of just, for whatever reason, feeling like, yeah, I should just take today and relax and feel better. So I'm going to walk around, just stay close, and call home, because I feel like that's going to make me feel a lot better. And if I just like tell myself it's okay to just relax and not have to go, I feel like I'm going to feel better. Am I probably feeling this way because of weird eating? Yeah, I probably am. But I mean, I had an egg earlier. I've been trying to keep better about food, and honestly, like, I can't eat breakfast tomorrow anyway for the appointment, so I'm disappointed. I really thought I should go, and I'm sick and tired of my life being run by feelings of very, very strong discomfort and anxiousness, and that's just not great. So as you can tell by this and this very nice oceanic band-aid, I had a doctor's appointment today, and I need to eat breakfast. It is 1:21. I still haven't eaten anything. My sleep hasn't been great, but I've realized a lot of my stressful feelings and things like that usually stem from lack of sleep, and my sleep has been weird because it's really, really warm lately, so I'm not surprised. And I've also, like, when I get up, I see like notifications on my phone for like emails and texts and stuff like that. They're not the literal notifications, but I check these things because I like feeling like things are happening in my life, and I get kind of anxious when they're not. So like, it feels good to wake up and like know what to expect from the day. With that being said, I'm literally exhausted. So yeah, I got the blood taken. They needed like to fill up like 5 different tubes, which was fun because I'm okay with needles, I'm not great with veins, but no matter what, you get 5 tubes worth of blood, and I had like a few in. I was like, I'm fine, no big deal. She's like, how are you feeling? I'm like, why should I be feeling weird? And that's the thing I know, I'm like, nope, I wanna lay down. Like, I was okay, but really warm. So yeah, they gave me a little bit of orange juice and opened up the thing. And the doctor's office, I actually really like it. The doctor was super cool, everyone was awesome. Like, honestly, like, it's great, and I'm glad it's great because this is awesome, because now I have a doctor and I have a good doctor's office to go to, and like, it just feels really, really super good because I feel good about this entire experience. And also, it's so close to me that, like, seriously, with the way that I was feeling on the way out, which I did get a little can of orange juice and stuff to try and feel better after they took the blood, and I also got the flu shot. Fun story about that in a second. But like, after I was having all this happen, they're like, yeah, might be a little bit out, but once you eat something, you'll be better, you'll be fine. So driving in this mindset would not have been fun had I had to go farther than I did. But guys, this is great. Like, I've never been so close to a doctor's office, nor did I ever think I'd be so excited to be, but like, yo, this is it. Like, this is actually amazing, because like, if you're driving yourself, you might as well, one, be comfortable with the area you're at, and two, you probably should also be comfortable with the idea of walking, driving, or just being close to begin with. Like, this is so perfect, it's not even funny, okay? Like, it's great. Yeah, so anyway, I'm in the kitchen because I still need to make breakfast. I'm just gonna have like an egg omelet situation to really just burst that energy back up. Fun story with the flu shot, I haven't been taking it. I usually don't care to. I'm usually, like, I took it a few times when I was younger and got really sick. So naturally, I don't technically normally think it's a good idea, but I was kind of convinced this time around, and only because for like, I wanted to see what the doctor's point of view was from an LA standpoint, because there are a lot of things I find are different in the medical field that I'll hear here versus back in New York. So I was curious to see, like, would they be pushing it, would they not be pushing it, like, what's their tea on this. And yep, just super cool, and just like, you know what, it's like totally up to me on this one. But like, me being like me person, anyway, she was just very cool with the idea of it is my decision. But ultimately, like, she basically just gave the whole rundown of like, this is what it does, this is what it's been in the past, this is what it is now. You may feel a little bit funky, but honestly, the reason, like, if I got the flu, it'd be a lot worse. If I got the flu plus the corona, it would be a million times worse. So she was honestly just like, if you have a day or two of feeling a little bit funky, and you might not even, like, I don't think I will, and I'm just needing food right now. But yeah, she was pretty chill about it and being like, yep. Yeah, anyway, that's my story. I do have things that I would like to do today, but honestly, groceries is just my top one. I didn't make it yesterday. I ended up walking around and calling help, which was so much better, and making cinnamon rolls, which was really better. But now I'm like, I still need groceries. So if I make it later, I'll make it later. But I think today I'm probably just going to keep it super easy, probably watch some whatever, like Bold Type or Emily Paris or something like that, and then sleep, take a nap, feel better, make some coffee, I don't even know. But that's where we're at today, so yay. A little bit of food goes a long way. That egg omelet slapped, it was pretty good. I kind of ate it like a savage, but you know what, we're feeling a lot better. A huge thing is structure, and obviously, as you know, last summer I was feeling a lot of like interesting things because I didn't really have structure. I was just going day by day and kind of like giving myself that time, but I've given myself over a year of that time. Granted, pandemic kind of struck, but like, it's still like, I just need some sort of structure and routine and expectation to my days. Not to say that what I'm doing doesn't have that, but like, it kind of doesn't. It doesn't really like have something. Like before, like, I knew, okay, I would prep for the parties on Thursdays and Fridays, I would be working the weekends and driving all around town, and then Mondays were my relaxing day, probably go to the bank, go to acting class later, and then Tuesday slept in. Like, that was my routine, and then like the middle days of the week were my weekend, and that's how I eventually got a stretcher in within my distance. And it's not exactly like that right now. But funny enough, last night while I was enjoying my cinnamon roll and just taking a minute, I found a new opportunity, which is great. So I'm going to set that up when I actually want to start, because it's one of those things like it's for We Audition, which I will probably end up cutting this part out if I don't end up doing it. But the thing is, there's this website called We Audition for Actors. And if you need a reader or you want to be a reader for scenes, you can use this website. So that's really cool in itself. I've used it kind of a little bit, but not much, but at this point. But like, if you do sign up and get a membership, I think it's like 10 bucks a month or $100 for a year, and you can also be a reader. So people could pay you, you set your own rates, and you could help read through other scenes. And I'm like, I should do this. Obviously, I want to find work that like I am kind of in control of, but also involves other people and also keeps me motivated, because that's how the acting class always felt, was it was a motivation. And I'd love to still do that right now, but one, it's not in person anymore, and also it costs money. And when rent is high enough to begin with, my thing right now is just like being good about money. Like, I've never really been bad with it, but I also like, I need to make more before I spend more, you know. And right now the only thing I'm really spending it on is just like food and obviously housing, so the essentials. That being said, I'm also still trying to work on that music album, so the second I think I get the money together, I'm going to really get that album together too, and probably reach out to just a few different people I know to see like about producing, because I'm okay with it, but I feel like I need some help. And like, also to know the music side of things like would probably be important in order to do this, because if I'm going to do it, I want to do it right and in a nice professional way, not just to be like, oh, I have music now. Like, I don't want to be like that. I honestly, like, I create it for fun, and I create it because it's like another emotional just storytelling device for me. And honestly, like, if I could share that with others and kind of spread light and love and positivity and happiness to others through my art, and if that's also through music, like, I would just, like, I feel like some things are meant to be shared, you know? Yeah, so that's the tea, that's the update. I know, I'm like backing off. This frame is not everything, we accept that. Anywho, so I'ma go, but that's my fun update, that's what's happening. I know it's like a lot, but yeah. Hello, it is precisely 5:16 in the afternoon and I'm still inside. I put on the air earlier, as you already heard, and yeah, keeping that going for a bit made it very comfortable in here. So I did my sheets, not the comforter, obviously. I don't send that in that often. I found out some really cool information, which was awesome, and I got started with website called We Audition. So if you are an actor, definitely check out this website. Seriously, it's so cool, and you can just like be a reader, get readers for your own projects and whatnot, and it's super helpful because the readers, especially me, will also give a lot of advice and help with your self-tapes and things like that. So pretty excited to be a part of this, very happy to get that set up. I set up more website photos onto my IMDb profile because I was like, you know what, I should probably have more than just a few headshots on there. And I just made sure all my profiles were back and thriving and living their best lives. We're back in the kitchen. Anyway, so I got the groceries. The second I left, I immediately realized I was exhausted. So I ate half a coffee Clif Bar. Yeah, you have to stop pretending like coffee is the answer when you're exhausted and you really need sleep. But it's good to know that that's just the problem. Because by the time I'm done with dinner and obviously taking a shower, putting all this stuff back onto my bed and everything, I'm going to sleep early. Like, I'm excited. So as you can hear, I'm making dinner. Amazing quality content. We've got some kale gnocchi with sourdough bread, if I feel like it, and like a marinara sauce situation. You know, that sounds good. I've also got some water going on because your girl is going to have some lemon tea, not even tea, just like lemon juice heated up with some water diluted out, and like maybe some honey, like a sprinkle of cinnamon, just a nice little immunity booster, you know, to feel like that's where we're at. So yeah, so I'm just over here thinking about the movie Aquamarine, which I haven't seen since I think last year. It's a great movie. I grew up with that movie. I love that movie. It's probably my top favorite movies ever. And I have yet another realization today that I just thought of while plopping in Kale Gnocchi, of how that movie has nicely shaped my existence. And I didn't even realize this one, so I was like, wow, interesting. So I don't know, I just had like a fun little realization about that movie. I was like, wow, like I'm pretty sure like watching, if I were to watch it today, which I kind of want to now, but if I like were actually to watch it, I'd realize there are a lot of things about that movie that connect to my modern day self, which is wild because like I've always really enjoyed that movie. So to be able to like watch that and know like I've been shaped by it, it's kind of cool. Like at this point, it's cool to find out what childhood movies and TV shows have shaped you as a person, because like when you notice those little things, like you just keep noticing them, you know? And this one was just wild. Anyway, I know that's not the most exciting piece of information, but like I said, I am tired. Okay, I'm gonna stop being annoying about being tired and carry on making my food. But yeah, today's been actually pretty chill. I'm excited to do the thing for the reads and stuff more tomorrow. Tomorrow I'm definitely going to stay in as much as I can, because I did everything today, and I also just want to stay healthy, especially considering I don't know how I'm going to react to the flu shot, but so far so good. Like, we're exhausted, but we're doing great. So that's that. Yeah, I'm gonna charge this battery now. Okay, bye.